So hello everyone, I'm Monica Bachchan and today I'm sitting with Mr. ACR Das, who is a metallurgical engineer from IIT Kanpur. He has started his career from Usha Martin Ranchi, then worked at SAIL, Bureau of Indian Standard, and contributed his golden 40 years to Ministry of Steel. He is the man behind in major decision making with regards to standards and quality, research and development, and energy and environment. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
So first of all, we would like to understand from you, why standard and quality is important for the country?
See, there are many facets to this question, but as you know, the standards are basic technical documents upon which the quality rests. If there is no standard, means there is no quality. Now, when you talk about standards, standards can be at various levels. At the company level, we have got company standards. Then there are national levels, we have got national standards, like we have got BIS, who formulate national standards. Then at international level, we have got ISO standards. So all these standards, the main purpose is to ensure that products or processes are made or evolve as per a particular standard. Now, standards are essentially required to ensure that we ensure the public safety, security of products, mm-hmm. not only products but right. processes, mm-hmm. and of, let us say, infrastructure, housing, or construction, mm-hmm. even for human health and environment protection. As you know, we have got BIS has published n number of standards, mm-hmm. and ultimately the purpose is to ensure that we make available quality steel to the public. Mm-hmm. So if there is no standards, we cannot ensure the availability of quality steel in the country. For example, you know, this TMT steel, mm-hmm. it is, I think it concerns all of us.
Right.
It goes for construction, mm-hmm. it goes for housing, right. it goes for infrastructure,
right.
and it is very critical to the safety of infrastructure and construction and housing, and of course at large human life. Mm-hmm. So we want to ensure that through standards we make available quality steel for all such critical applications.
Okay. In spite of so many standards for Indian steel, why country is still consuming low quality steel or non-standard steel?
See, let me first of all tell you that standards by definition are voluntary documents.
Okay.
So, even if you have the standards, it doesn't mean that the products will be made as per the quality parameters prescribed in the standards, just because it is voluntary. Now, so that is the main reason that in Indian context, all the standards are not mandatory. So, adoption of the standards depends on various factors, mm-hmm. and I think one of the main parameter is the lack of consciousness or awareness of the public. If the public want a product as per the standards, definitely people will make available that type of steel or any product for that matter, mm-hmm. to the public. You know, the Indian context, the our market is governed by the price.
Yes.
So yes. what happens if a product is available at lower price or a product is cheaper, people tend to purchase those type of thing, and at that time they don't realize the importance of the life cycle or importance of the quality, etc. But later on they might repent. Mm-hmm. So this is the problem, that one is the voluntary nature of the standard, the other is the lack of public awareness. These are the main two parameters. And another parameter which I can think is, you know, this at the producer's front also,
yeah.
it lacks marketing efforts. Mm-hmm. And till recently you might have seen in the market, mm-hmm. the on this front the steel producers were lacking very much. But today we have, I think they have learned that unless you advertise the importance, mm-hmm. or you market importance of quality, mm-hmm. or market steel, mm-hmm. or educate the consumers, this does not happen. So ultimately That is the third parameter which had been affected, affecting the marketing of steel or marketing of standards.
So, Mr. Das, you are saying that both the consumer and the steel manufacturer, they are at a fault. So, the steel manufacturer is not doing the awareness programs and proper marketing to educate the customers, and customers on just on the basis of price and discount, they are ready to compromise on the quality.
Yes, I think that is very much correct, and that I think a lot needs to be done by the steel producers particularly. And also, I should say government, why not? The government should, as like we have a program called Jago Grahak Jago.
Right.
Now that type of program is more of some consumer goods. Mm-hmm. So I want that type of program should be, I think government should think of promoting such type of programs for the steel products also.
And you think Ministry of Steel can participate in certain schemes and plans which central government can propose, like Jago Grahak Jago? In the same line, if they do it for housing and steel which is consumed in housing.
Yes, I think that is very, very important. In fact, there was some program in the government and the Ministry of Steel in association with ISDAG.
For affordable housing.
To promote or to start a campaign program to promote the consumption of quality steel in this sector, in all sectors of the economy, particularly the construction sector, particularly TMT and particularly structural steel. But some of that has not happened, but in my opinion that is very important agenda, and Ministry of Steel must come up for that type of program, and along with the steel producers of course.
So you think they should again start with the affordable housing program of INSTAG, and they can come up with more schemes and plans?
Yes, that is true, but my point is that educating the consumers and educating also the steel producers about the importance of quality, and ultimately making available quality steel to the consumers. That should be the main focus of the producers, consumers and also the government.
So, what do you think, why quality control order is important for steel manufacturers as well, for Indian steel companies? How it is important?
See, as I told you, the quality control order, what does it say? What is quality control order for that matter? See, quality control order says only one thing, that you should produce and make available steel to the consumers as per a particular standard. Now that applies not only to domestic production but also to import. So when you import a product, that must conform to a particular quality standard prescribed by BIS. In fact, as per the BIS Act, we say that the product must conform, whether it is produced in India or abroad, or whether it is produced by one of the best producers in the world is Nippon Steel. But even their product must conform to the Indian standard. Let me tell you, the purpose of the quality control order is to make available quality steel to the consumers.
Yes.
Now, the steel is produced either domestically or it is imported.
Yeah.
So, quality control order ensures that whether it is produced domestically or it is imported, it must conform to the quality. It must conform to the minimum standard prescribed in our Indian standard. So, even if the steel produced abroad conforms to a foreign standard, it has to conform to the Indian standard.
And it also impacts trade practices.
Yes.
Trade practices.
Now, having said that, two important parameters are there. Like, first of all, you are making available quality steel. Mm-hmm. What does it mean? You are indirectly banning production, sale, usage of substandard steel.
Right.
So, quality control order is very useful in prohibiting the use of substandard steel in the country. Mm-hmm. In fact, I can give you one example. Mm-hmm. You know, the country was flooded with import of CRGO steel, and almost 60 to 65% second hand defective.
Okay.
That was indirectly affecting our T&D losses. So after the quality control order, Now import of seconds and defective has almost come down to zero. So this is the impact of quality control order, and that indirectly helps the producer abroad or in India to make available this type of quality steel for a critical end use application, and ultimately for safety of infrastructure, safety of what you call engineering machineries, like say CRGO steel is used for manufacture of transformers. And that is a very critical product, a critical equipment. So quality CRGO is very important for that type of product.
So Mr. Das, I have a question for you. Like if we talk about TMT bars, for example, we have been getting news about Mumbai footover bridge collapse, which was made of totally steel. Then there was a flyover which got collapsed at Kolkata. There was some building collapse in Varanasi. There had been a series of news in last 1 or 2 years where we were seeing bridges are collapsing, flyovers are collapsing, or buildings are collapsing. Do you think these collapses are the result of bad quality of TMT bars which have been used, or it is a collaborated effect of bad quality of cement or architectural default or design problem, or it is mainly because of steel quality?
Yeah, it is a very good question and burning issue as of date. But let me tell you that we cannot say, and nobody can say, that it is only because of the single factor about the quality of steel alone. Because a building, it depends on so many parameters. Of course, quality of steel is a very important parameter. Similarly, quality of steel and quality of the basic, the design. Design is a very important parameter. Now, and ultimately the life of the building. I think most of the buildings, what you have talked about, there are many cases which are new, but these, for example, Bombay case, this was a very old bridge and it has collapsed. So I can only say that these are effect or the results of many parameters, not only steel, but steel is a very important parameter.
Okay. So can you please indicate some advantages of quality control order and challenges which companies are facing with regards to quality control order?
See, Monica, as I told you in the beginning, the main purpose or objectives or advantage of the quality control order is to make available quality steel to the public at large. Now, this is what we are saying through the quality control order is that when you are making available steel, whether imported or domestic, it must conform to your quality. And so that the public who is using, and ultimately it is going to be used in particular sector, we must ensure the safety and security and other parameters. Now, you know, the added advantage of the quality control order as per the BIS Act is to, you are empowering the customers, or you are empowering the consumers to seek legal course. What I want to say that suppose somebody supplies substandard material, so there is a provision in the BIS Act that he or she can seek legal course. So I think that is a very important provision provided in the BIS Act, and that is enacted through the quality control order.
And why all steel standards are not incorporated in quality control order?
Yeah, I think this is a question which is asked to me quite often. You know, in India, let me come to Indian context. That here we have got n number of standards. In fact, for steel, let me tell you, country steel, we have got n number of standards. One is for process, one is for product, one is for say testing procedures, etc. Even glossaries, they are also standards. But I am concerned, quality control order is concerned about the product standards. Like TMT is a product, CRGO is a product. Now we have got around, I think just today, I don't know the current figure, but it should be around 140 product standards. Out of that, so far we have notified how much, about 53, I think 53 standards. And in fact, if you see the website of Ministry of Steel, they have notified draft standard for, draft quality controller for 13 more products. Now, In quantitative terms, let me tell you, these 53 standards cover about 80 to 85% total steel production and consumption in the country. So, although it looks very less in terms of number, 140 versus 53, but in terms of quantity, it is very high, it is 85. So, today, what is not covered is only alloy and special steel or niche steel products.
So, Mr. Das, if we put quality control order on all the standards of steel, which includes steel furnitures, steel bed, almirahs, table sofas, don't you think the cost of steel will go up really high? Or you think it is still remain competitive for the end user?
See, I really don't agree with the viewpoint that the price will jack up if the quality control order is implemented. There are two issues I want to tell you.
Okay.
First of all, you see, BIS, when you go for BIS standard marking, you have to take a license from BIS. That cost is not much. Then after taking a license, you have to mark the product, or there is some nominal fees from BIS. So in principle, I want to say that the price of products should not go up. Yes, there are representations from the industry at times that many steels are produced and used for non-critical sector. So what is the need of quality control order or for that matter standards? I really don't agree with that viewpoint also, because if you go to abroad or any developed countries, nobody use substandard steel. They use only standard steel. So there is no point or there is no justification to say that we use substandard steel for some critical, non-critical product. At least I don't buy these arguments. But in a country like India, yes, what we have done in the Ministry of Steel some time back, that we have created some standards for non-critical applications, like for TMT bars, or it is for structural steel, which are not load bearing. So there we have, these products so far we have not included the quality control order. And earlier there was a decision to not to include these products under the quality control order. So that is what is continuing as on date, but I won't be able to tell you the future course of action by the government.
Okay. So do you think Indian steel manufacturers are capable enough to produce quality steel as per the quality control order? You think all manufacturers can produce that quality of steel?
In fact, this is a million-dollar question. See, you know, as far as integrated steel plants are concerned, or many of the mini steel plants are concerned, they are very much equipped to produce quality products as per the Indian standard, and for that matter, as per any standard abroad. Because as you know, we are exporting steel also.
Yes.
And exporting means as per the international standard. So we are producing steel as per the international standard. There is no problem at all. But yes, there are some problems in the in Indian steel sector, particularly in the secondary sector. And there also I want to mean the induction furnace and the steel rolling mills. There are certain technological issues, like, you know, induction furnace, we cannot refine the steel. Refine the steel to reduce the phosphorus. We can reduce the sulfur, but we cannot reduce the phosphorus. And phosphorus, high phosphorus is very, very injurious to the quality of the steel or to the safety and security. Ultimately, it makes the steel brittle. So this is a big issue in the country. And let me tell you one point, that Ministry of Steel has been taking so much intervention, particularly through R&D, to reduce the phosphorus in the induction furnace steel. Of course, this proposal or these results of the R&D project has not been implemented because of it jacks up the price to some extent. But another very important development has taken place in the induction furnace industry. They have developed a cost economic ladle furnaces. In fact, wherein you can produce quality steel through the induction furnace route.
So is quality control order is applicable for both import and exported steel as well?
Yes. See, the as per WTO regulations, you cannot give differential treatment to import and domestic steel. So whether it is produced domestically or imported, you have to apply the quality control order. Now, there are certain exceptions, like when you are importing a steel under advance authorization scheme of DGFT or Ministry of Commerce, that is basically for export promotion.
Right.
So there the quality control order is not applicable. Similarly, when you are producing in India steel for export, because export means, as I told in the earlier case, that you have to export the steel as per international standards, as per foreign standard. So there also it doesn't apply. But let us say you are importing a steel as per any standard for domestic consumption.
Right.
But for that also, the quality control order applies very much.
Okay. So last question I want to ask you. What is the surveillance mechanism for proper implementation of quality control order for both domestically procured steel and for imported steel?
Yeah, it's a very good question. See, the Indian standard BIS Act as such, it provides the surveillance mechanism. But when we issued the quality control order, we issued it under the old BIS Act.
Okay.
1986. So at that time we had a provision called appropriate authorities, as per which we got Ministry of Steel, State Government, Director of Industries and BIS as the enforcement agencies or authorities.
Right.
And as per the new act, it is basically BIS who has to take action or implement the quality control order. Now, at the ground level, you see, the for imported steel, it is a customs. They check, and they, unless the product conforms to the standard, or the, unless they find that the product has been certified by BIS abroad, or certified by the company as per BIS procedure, they will not allow it to clear the import. So, it is being enforced by the customs for imported steel. And for domestic as well as for imported steel, BIS has overriding power. They can search and seize any steel and find out whether the product is good or bad, or they can test the quality.
Okay. So you want to give any message to the steel industry, steel manufacturers?
While in the Ministry of Steel, and even now I have been promoting the quality control orders. And I want to say that they must produce as per the quality. And yes, there are certain problems and issues in real implementation. So these must be resolved by the Ministry of Steel in consultation with the users.
Okay, thank you so much, Mr.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.